Welcome everybody to another round of Tally CA Connect. Today we have a CA Vahina Dogia here, a young energetic CA. Okay, yes, absolutely ma'am, you heard that right. Taking us on the intricacies of GST and the provisions in Tally that can help really increase efficiency to a great extent. Let me introduce the speaker today. So let me introduce CA Vahina Dogia, who is full of life and energy. She is a qualified CA in Jan 1998, and she has done LLB from KC College. She has done a diploma in systems audit from ICAI, and her journey of learning is still as on as she is recently qualified as forensic audit and fraud detection. She has completed forensic audit and fraud detection certificate course from ICAI. She has also qualified as an independent director managed by the Indian Institute of Corporate Affairs. She is a Tally evangelist and a motivational speaker too. In span of 12 years, she has served the CA profession as co-opted and subgroup members of various committees of WIRC of ICAI. Presently, she is subgroup member of Management Accounting Committee of WIRC of ICAI for the year 2021, where she is actively coordinating for the e-publication of the book of virtual CFO services. She is also a committee member of coaching class committee of GST-PAM. She is an advisory group member of Gorivli Study CP Circle, having more than 1700 members, where she also served a convener for the year 2000 to 2005. She has started Women Wing of BCSC and SPES. She is a lifetime member of various professional associations like AIFTP, GSTPM, BCS, CTC, and MCTC. He has addressed more than 100 study circle meetings and workshops on various platforms, including that of WIRC. She is an active social contributor and a very good singer. He has founded International Fellowship of Rotarian Musician Chapters in 2017, and now she is the treasurer of same. She is vice president of Rotary Club of Gorivli of 2021. Serving in various organizations like Harmony Music Club, Gorivli Junior Chamber, HVO Students Association, and other various posts. With that brief note, let me now hand over the mic to Vanna Madam. And over to you, Vanna Ma'am. Please help us.
Thank you, Janak, for inviting me in such a wonderful platform, but your voice was not clear. And we were trying to inform you through the chat. One thing I can say about me is just Vandana Dogia, Google out. So that's what is all about. Here we are meeting today for understanding the GST. My first understanding will be that let us understand how many of you have already configured. Jara chat box pe dalenge. Already configured. So I can start with the inception of the company, master configuration se leke. I can show you the whole GST gimmick. And I always say that master configuration is a subject in itself. We must encash that opportunity as a chartered accountant or as a layman also. Someone who knows Tally should work on that line. My screen is visible to you. Rahul, Megha, who can tell me?
Yes, one is visible.
And the screen is visible, and the question is that what I need to understand is that shall we start from the because Tally Prime configuration is little different, not 100%. So if we start with a fresh company, so let's start with the Tally Prime. Will that be okay with all the participants, audience? That's what I was thinking. So let's have one unique company where we can start to end. We understand everything from the GST perspective. So ideally, I wanted today. First, we'll have a small 5 to 10 minutes to composition also, because क्या होता है composition को कोई address ही नहीं करता, but tally के अंदर composition बनाया गया है, उसको कैसे set करना है, वो एक दो मिनट मैं चाहती थी कि मैं बताऊँ लोगों को. Now you can see tally. So if I want, everyone knows now, it is like a file browser kind of thing. You can just press up pe jaake main press enter kar rahi hu, aur samjhe ki mera koi client jo hai general stores wala, uske upar jaake hum dekh lete hain ki. And I always insist security control should be in place whenever you work. That is the ideal way of working. अब हमारा F11 was the configuration. जब भी भी कुछ भी configure करना है, तो यहाँ पे enable goods and service tax yes, Maharashtra composition, date हमने डाली है, उनका GST number डाला है, और tax rate for taxable turnover is 1% and basis for tax calculation is taxable value. So that also you need to configure while in the start. Enable tax rate for purchase includes purchase under RCM. अगर by chance वहाँ पे RCM है तो आप yes कर सकते हो. So that is what I wanted to highlight. कि here in TelePrime even composition accounting can be managed. You need to understand how it is been configured. Display DOG and then GST CLP 08. So the moment you do the, it will show you the period. See, right now we are in the 21-22 open tha. Tally has a that thing ke wo last wala aapko dikhata hai. And your turnover, yahan pe one uncertain transaction. So you need to address that taxability, reverse charge, applicability, taxable value. You must be noticing that just now I enabled RCM and that purchase. So that's why this item has been captured by the tally. Then I need to check whether control enter करके आप voucher के अंदर जाके देख सकते हो कि क्या transaction है और उसका क्या applicability है. अब मुझे set off तो लेना ही नहीं है, but GSTR 4A जब जाता है, उनका annual return जब जाता है composition dealer का, at that time government needs that you also supply them the purchase details, you know. So I will try to, sir, because I am from India, so Hindi becomes part of my language. I will try to make it as English as possible. Okay. So where I was say I am from Maharashtra, and there is a composition dealer. Composition dealer have to pay 1% on a taxable turnover, and then purchase also configuration. Just now I changed the configuration, so one item now falls in the uncertain transaction. Control enter. I did the control enter and I checked the transactions and I just wanted to know, okay, what is the transaction is all about. Now I know, okay, this is just a summary I have to make because GSTR, jaise for regular dealer 2A comes, for composition dealer 4A comes in the GST website and they want to tag in, lock in, because some people also buys. If I am a composition dealer, I may buy from the regular dealer. So there are chances of matching concept, and that's why they had then you know, government wanted. So last year onwards they asked us to also keep the purchase summary ready. So you need to configure your tally accordingly so that you get the desired result. Now for me, I have to exclude this voucher because ultimately it is doesn't form part of my CMP 08. So I have excluded that voucher. And now we have the all transactions here, taxable sales. So let's, if I press enter, I will see the sales entry, cash in hand, check sales, month wise. हमने जो entry डाली है, consolidated entry, वो वहाँ पे display हो रही है. So आप Excel में उनका register maintain कर सकते हैं and month and one entry only you can park. Composition dealers को how you can minimize your time and maximize your return result. This is how one should be parking the entries. And there are exempted sales also because this is a composition dealer. Mainly kya hota hai, wo jaise grocery shop, general stores, they are dealing in say wheat, which is exempt item. So there will be exempt sales also. That also consolidated one entry we have parked here. So monthly we are parking, and here my everything has been generated by the tally. The tally gives me the result what I need to file the return, and then you can use the GSTN utility, or I have Winman, so I use Winman. So that is how it works. So I just wanted 5 minutes to run through the GST composition. Generally nobody shows composition, that's what was my intention. So here also GSTR 4 also is generated from the system. That is what we need to showcase. Okay, let's go to now regular dealer. So him like you know, dealer, I was asking time and again, their ready-made data is there. You want to go through that, or you want me to start from the scratch and understand how actually one should address the multi percentage item as well as complying all the possible you can say advance received from the client as far as the service industry is concerned, and RCM when trader or service industry anyone is concerned, wherever RCM is applicable. So that transaction I wanted to showcase you. Also, we can have a voucher class defined that can automize your transactions. You know, that's all also I wanted to showcase. So any one of you can just make what is your requirement from today's session, so I can you know, go through that. So shall I start from the master's configuration from scratch? It will take 5-10 minutes, not more. Basic accounts you need to create, and then I can just run through that. So we'll make more informative the session as it can be. You know. Are you with me? I need some yes, if possible.
Yeah, participants can use the chat box.
Can you reply me in chat box? Okay, so I'll generate. So let's come to the main tally screen. Here is the create company. All of us know I'm using the mouse and then pressing enter on that. So today's session, say we have tally GST session. Okay, that's my company's name. Now they have made it region is change country. I am in India. I take select India. Then my state Maharashtra. Then pin code you can specify. Your telephone, mobile. My mobile number I will write for the participant. Then there is an email address. Vandana.Dodia@gmail.com. Then comes the website. So www.ca1.com. So when you create this company, why this data is important? Understand, whenever you will sending any email to the outside client or party or any reports you are emailing, the data must is big master creation, master slave lineage ending. So whatever you are creating here, the address what you mention here will be picked up and will be sent in the email. So the tally picks up the data from here. Let's start the beginning. Now financial year beginning from 1st April, books beginning can be from the today itself because my business started today. So that is why two dates are given there. Understand that thing. Anybody can start the business in the middle of the year and that's why it is shown there. Security control, yes, karna hai. Then only aapka audit version bhi start hota hai or your data is secure. So you put your password, user ID and password. You are not allowed to forget the password. Very important. You people should remember your password. Your data will become redundant if you forget. So tally is prompting you. Movement, there is a security control. Tally is asking you enable tally audit features. So those of you who are not putting your data in password, you will never come to know that there is a tally audit feature exists. Okay. An auditor, as an auditor, as a chartered accountant, I say I will audit the data only. It is under local key. It is secure. I can be, somebody should be answerable, okay? Then I will just press control and save as it is. So, my one company created. Ho rahi hai. Company ka data path waha pe upar tha, wo aap change kar sakte ho, but I have not changed it, okay? So, main jahan pe D02 mein thi, wahi pe ye company created ho gayi hai. Then I will move it later on. Okay, so now what happens, the tally takes you to immediately to the F11 features. Previously, what was happening? F11, we press karna padta tha. So I have a choice. What I want to step by step, I want to keep maintain accounts. Yes. Enter bill by entry. Yes. Cost center. Cost center. When you have a branches or different or head office or you know another unit is there, you can use them as a profit center. Generally, I think in a school, you can school accounting. You can use cost center in any company where there is an office and branches separately there. But in the same state, so ideally you can use this feature of cost center accounting. Then interest calculation, very important. You can use interest calculation in your day-to-day like bank mein loan hai, wahan pe bhi. When you have a loan taken from unsecured parties, there also you can take this benefit. Sundry debtors, if you are eligible to collect interest if the party is delaying the payment. then also yes, then in case of creditors also. So wherever interest is there, tally is allowing you to redeemate interest module. When you activate this, it will be really make your life simplified. That's what. So if you say yes, I will also showcase you the report. So see, what I am trying to tell you is that our feature is not enabled, you will not get the outcome or benefit of it. So then going on slowly from this, integrate accounts with inventory. All of us know when I want to pick up the valuation of inventory, I need to pick this up from the this statutory. Yes, if I don't want to pick up the value of closing inventory, I can say no. What do you, I mean to say is that I will put the valuation with my own figures, but obviously it will be realistic one. So ideally you need to understand this rest thing lecture itself we will keep in the next time. I will now jump to GST. Yeah, what was the basic very important features which are must, I have explained you. We'll have a next session where we can only take up this features explanations. That's what Janak, I'll request you, we can take up the session on understanding the enabling of features and then the reporting. Whatever you enable, you will get the answer to that. जैसे ही हम yes करेंगे GST को, हमारे लिए regular dealer का ये pop-up window will open in Tally, the next screen. Am I going speedy or it's okay? The speed is fine with you all. You need to put proper GST number.
With your GST, that's one, it's fine.
Come again?
Yeah, it's okay. The speed is fine.
तो उन्होंने पॉपअप किया ना, देयर हैज टू बी सम एरर इन दिस. आई थिंक इट शुड बी थ्री. ओके, सी व्हाट आई वाज ट्राइंग टू हाईलाइट वाज द मोमेंट आई प्रेस जीरो, इट हैज पॉप्ड मी के चेक योर जीएसटी नंबर. सो देयर इज सम इंटरनल मैकेनिज्म विद टैली. Tally also, I think, somewhere searches and prompts us that the number is wrong. And moment I kept the right number, it has shown me without any error message, it has taken me to the next one. Depending on I have selected monthly or quarterly, I will have to select here. So if I select quarterly and then set under GST details, yes, what is it all about? Company level if you want to lock it. So ideally, suppose you are in a service industry, like I am a chartered accountant, so my outward supply will be always 18%. So I can define GST on a company level. For the traders, you may have 5% item, 12% item, 18%, 28%. So ideally, it is not advisable to do at a company level. You can do at a group level. So all 5% group level item at one go. So suppose one group is carrying 100 items, you don't need to put percentage in all the 100 items. You can park them in a one specified group of 5% item. So the group will take care of the percentage of GST. Okay. Enable tax liability on advance receipt. Yes, it is for service industries. I again repeat, we are taking one company only. Well, where we will be having services as well as goods, both we are supplying. Okay. So I will say yes. If I will say yes here, then only my voucher entry will be enabled to factor the advance receipt. Then reverse charge. Okay, yes, I will have the transport charges where I am supposed to pay, or as a service industry, I may have a lawyer, or if for that matter, trader can also hire a lawyer where RCM is attracted and I need to pay in a reverse charge mechanism. The RCM is my liability, GST is my liability. No doubt, whenever I pay RCM, on a payment basis, I can take the set off of the same. So that is the it is the some good things happening with us. Only compliance we have to look into. So then carrying on to the next, enable GST classification. Yes, provide LTU bonds. So those of you who are dealing in LTU bonds, up here, but yes, when you say yes, it will prompt you to enter the bond number and the validity period. Okay, so that is how Tally has factored it. Now even till applicable, yes, from whichever period. So if the company started from 1st April, so I am writing 1st April invoice value. I will always take an invoice value, so to avoid the ambiguity. And threshold limit in Maharashtra is 50,000 is there. Applicable for interest rate, yes, Now it has become 1 lakh for interested. So I will change it to 1 lakh. Applicable for interested, it is 50,000. So depending in whichever state you are in India and finding out what is your threshold, you have to configure this. This is one time exercise. Okay. Now Tally is also geared up that if your company is having more than 100 crore turnover, you can have e-invoicing applicable. Say yes. Applicable from date also, the date when you fall into that regime, you can put that date. And bill from place. Now there are two things. You may have the head office and there will be a factory. So you can have a billing to be done from one place. So say Mumbai, whatever place you want to do, and default period of the e-invoice report is say 3 days. I can keep 2 days depending on my choice. And send e-way bill details with invoice. Yes, obviously I will like them to see, keep the record of the e-way bill also. So this was on the part of GST. Now if I'm going to show you lawyer ka GST also. So lawyer, when we give more than 30,000 professional fees, we will also enable TDS for that matter, because right now we are in this module feature. I will also enable TDS, and you put the 10 number and everything here so that TDS features are activated. And now I will just save this control A. Control A means accept as it is the screen, whatever you contained you have now designed will be saved for the future reference purpose. Now once we have created the masters, now let's go to create the certain ledger. पहले हम ledger बना लेते हैं, फिर items बना लेंगे, फिर हम voucher type बना लेंगे. So everything in the master configuration we will be dealing with. See, it's so simple in Tally. Movement, your masters are created properly. Data entry person has to just mean the data. Are we getting? And then only arithmetical accuracy will be problem. Like 5 to 6, the उन्होंने 6 to 5 लिख दिया. That only needs to be addressed. Rest the Tally will take care. You know. So let's go and create certain. So create में जब जैसे ही जाते हैं, वो पहले ही मुझे पूछ रहा है group, ledger, currency, voucher type, and stock group, stock item, unit. तो सबसे पहले तो स्टॉक आइटम में आपको यूनिट क्रिएट करना पड़ेगा. अगर हम डील कर रहे हैं फॉर एग्जांपल पीसीज में या नंबर्स में, आई विल बी टेकिंग अप द एग्जांपल ऑफ से मोबाइल कंपनी. सो लेट्स राइट नंबर्स, देन फॉर्मल नेम इज नंबर्स, देन यूनिट क्वांटिटी कोड यू हैव टू सिलेक्ट फ्रॉम दिस लिस्ट प्रोवाइडेड बाय द टैली. And number of decimal places are very crucial. Whenever I give lectures, I say be careful, because it is now editing is little difficult. Transactions that happens. So ideally, other number, obviously you are dealing in absolute figures, so it should be zero. Numbers, I am going to sell say charger or mobile phone, so it is absolute numbers. So there is no decimal required. Okay, so I am having one this thing, and I will. Say come to item we create कर लेते हैं साथ साथ में. So before creating the item, आपका group ready होना चाहिए. So if I started, I came to this screen. So Tally is always helpful to me. So I am just typing say mobile instrument. Then primary की जगह पे मुझे एक group create करना है. Alt C करके it gives me a window. There is a flexibility. Stock group creation window is opening up for me, and I say. In fact, mobile instrument is my group, and different type of mobiles will be my item. So that is under primary. Now in primary also finish goods, raw material, जिनको जो जो applicable है. हम अभी dealer का trader का ले रहे हैं. अगर आप manufacturing concern का जब GST configuration कर रहे हैं या master configuration कर रहे हैं, तो आपको जब आइटम क्रिएट करते हैं या उसका स्टॉक ग्रुप क्रिएट, व्हेन यू क्रिएट अ स्टॉक ग्रुप, प्लीज टेक केयर, यू आल्सो टेक केयर ऑफ रॉ मटेरियल, वर्क इन प्रोग्रेस और अ फिनिश्ड गुड्स, दैट कैन बी द ग्रुप हेडिंग, एंड अकॉर्डिंगली यू पार्क दैट आइटम इन अंडर दैट ग्रुप. ओके, सो दिस इज माय प्राइमरी आइटम. फॉर मी एवरीथिंग इज से रेडीमेड गुड्स, सो इट विल बी प्राइमरी. शुड क्वांटिटीज ऑफ आइटम टू बी एडेड, से यस. व्हाई? It is in stock report. When you watch the reporting, na, if you have not said yes, it will not give you the count of total items. So if you have 10 items in that particular group, so the totality may total, if you want to see, it will not give you unless you have said yes here. So while creating the things, you need to understand the group ka total. If you need to watch or see or in reporting you want the total of the group items, then you say yes here. Now I already told you, if the item is carrying the same percentage, I can define here, so my group will take care of my GST percentage. So if I for instrument, I will say yes, my all instrument has the same rate of GST. I will have a Samsung ka mobile, I will have Redmi, Realme, Apple, whatever may be the five mobile different instrument, but my mobile instrument group will carry this because there is the same rate of interest, rate of GST. So say yes, and then here I can define this classification. I don't recollect, so right now I will put just adjacent code. So agar mujhe pata hai mobile ka adjacent code kya hai, I can go to the website and check. Okay, I want adjacent code for mobile. एक्सेसरीज चाहिए या हैंडसेट चाहिए, हैंडसेट चाहिए अपने को, इंस्ट्रूमेंट है ना अपना, सो 8517, सो आई विल पुट 8517, ओके, एंड इट इज हैंडसेट, ओके, टैक्सेबिलिटी, ऑब्वियसली इट हैज टू बी टैक्सेबल, मैंने नील रेटेड कर दिया, मुझे उसको चेंज करना पड़ेगा, ओके, देन रिवर्स चार्ज, अभी ये तो मेरा गुड्स है, सो रिवर्स चार्ज हैज नथिंग टू डू, इनएलिजिबल क्रेडिट वो भी नहीं एप्लीकेबल है, से माय रेट इज 18% on this thing, so मैंने इसको save कर दिया. And now I want to change it. यहाँ पे मुझे लिखती हूँ Apple. यहाँ पे numbers and I can just save it. I don't need to go and keep on putting the GST rate as well as the classification. It will take the group का classification. Apple ले लिया मैंने, Samsung ले लिया. Samsung mobile, mobile instrument, numbers and then फिर मुझे क्या चाहिए और एक डाल, ठीक है, उसके बाद अगर हमें एक नया ग्रुप क्रिएट करना है यूएसबी चार्जर, देन आई विल क्रिएट ऑल सी से अनदर ग्रुप मोबाइल, और यहाँ पे मैं गया था अभी सेशंस, तो अगेन इट इज 85, उसमें भी देखो उसने केबल का अलग अलग, देखो यहाँ पे परसेंटेज भी अलग है, तो हमें वही चाहिए था, मेमोरी कार्ड का अलग है, इसका अलग है, स्पीकर्स का अलग है, हेडफोन का अलग है, सो वी विल हैव दिस प्रोडक्ट, फोर प्रोडक्ट्स वी विल बी टेकिंग फ्रॉम हियर, ओके, सो आई नीड दिस एक्सेसरीज, मैंने कंट्रोल सी किया और यहाँ पे आगे सिर्फ कंट्रोल वी करना है मुझे, दिस इज माई प्राइमरी ग्रुप, ओके, should quantity to be added, yes. Now I will not write GST details here. Why? Because my items falling under this group will be having a different rate of GST, okay? So here I will go and now I will say yes. So my USB charger HSN code is 8504 on value taxable and what was the rate was 28%, okay? So I will save it and goods. Then there is something called memory card. Memory card 8523. Memory card primary है, वहाँ पे accessory ले लिया, numbers ले लिया, applicable yes कर दिया. यहाँ पे आपने 8523 ले लिया और यहाँ पे आपने taxable ले लिया. Now it is 18%. So two different percentage in the same group need to be. Item wise you have to rate setup karna hai, that's what I wanted to make you understand. So two things we have now covered, speakers, headphones, theek hai, mobile covers ka kya hai wo mujhe dekhna hai rate, I wanted something in a 5% item, no, so it is everybody is a higher rate for me, so it's okay, one or two item is fine with us, let's go with certain now. दो चीज मैंने ले ली, परसेंटेज मैंने समझा दिया, आई मेड यू अंडरस्टैंड दैट व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन कंपनी लेवल, इफ यू आर जस्ट डीलिंग इन वन प्रोडक्ट और वन सर्विसेज आइडियली ऑन कंपनी लेवल, ग्रुप इफ द ग्रुप द आइटम अंडर द ग्रुप हैज द सेम जीएसटी रेट्स, यू कैन सेटल इट एट अ ग्रुप लेवल, एंड आइटम हैव अ डिफरेंट रेट बट कंपाइल्ड इन वन ग्रुप, सो आइटम वाइज जीएसटी रेट्स यू हैव टू कॉन्फिगर, ओके. So now this thing is done. Now I will go to the ledger creation. So let's go to ledger. Now we all know that sales and purchase, we don't need to go inside and decide the classification. We can have the classification at the transaction level. So it is depends on the company to company or a person to person to take care of. Ideally, Tally has given flexibility. Once I say sales, it will now take up data is from Maharashtra, then it will take local sales, then CGST, SGST, and then interstate sales. If the person is not, that data is, when you create the data ledger, the Tally will pick up from the state of supply from the data which you create and you input the data over there. Okay. Whatever state you specify there. So Tally has, see, any software will have some logic. So wherever something is parked, it will pick up the data from that particular field. Data is always structured in the field. So let's understand. So right now I'm opening one sales account for you, for a specific client. If they are unable to understand, you can have two different sales ledger, one being local sales, one being interstate sales. But only problem is that classification should not do, because Tally mein kya hota hai, when you go inside, it will ask you for the percentage. I'll show you with the example. Suppose I'm writing sales under sales account. Then I just go down applicable, and if I say yes, it will यहाँ पे अगर मुझे रेट मेरा फिक्स हो जाता है तो वो मुझे आई वॉन्टेड टू अवॉइड, अब मुझे HSN तो डालना ही नहीं है यहाँ पे, फिर वो नॉट एप्लीकेबल करके मुझे टैक्सेबल करना है बस और कुछ नहीं करना है, तो वो मुझे रेट स्पेसिफिकली पूछता है. अब आई एम डीलिंग इन 18% आइटम ऑल्सो, 28% आइटम ऑल्सो, तो आई डोंट वॉन्ट टू डिफाइन एनीथिंग हियर, अंडरस्टैंड दैट थिंग, नोर आई वॉन्ट लोकल और इंटरस्टेट सेल्स डिफाइंड हियर. I want, so I don't need to get inside and I have to just save it. That is, understand, when you have two different rates, more than one rate, not two different rates, you are supplying something which is carrying different rates, then don't go into sales account and configure the percentage. Otherwise, you will always have a problem, okay, while putting the transaction. So ideally, just create the sales ledger, don't go inside and don't do anything, okay. Then is purchase account. Here also it is your choice. Yeah, I want reports in a format the way I want a format. I want local purchase segregated. I want interstate purchase segregated. You can open two different ledger heads. You know, so for that matter, purchases you can have a local. Local means within state. You can write always within state. That is the proper jargon nowadays. What we use. So this is the purchases within state. Here also same logic. I will say don't write not applicable. Likho agar if it is not applicable. Okay, and then control R, purchase interstate, and then purchase account. Okay, goods not applicable. Similarly, now I want to edit my sales account. So I want to alter Alt G मैंने press किया, alter master. I want to alter my ledger. जो कि हम follow कर रहे हैं purchase में, let's have the same thing in sales. Why? Because in voucher class, I may like to choose two separate ledger account. That's why you can have one also, but then every time you need to have that segregation. Sales, interstate sales and local sales. That classification every time you will be required to do. So it is ideally save your time. See, ultimately your work should be saving your time. Your data entry operator or your accountant should not invest time in doing the repeated job. It should be automatically coming from Tally. That is what our intention should be. परसेंटेज के प्रॉब्लम की वजह से मैं यहाँ पे अभी कुछ नहीं लिख रही हूँ. ओके, नाउ आई वांट टू क्रिएट लेजर, कंट्रोल आर, सेल्स इंटरेस्टिंग. थोड़ा आपको लगेगा कि ये प्रिमिटिव है, लेकिन ये फाउंडेशन, अगर आपका ये फाउंडेशन क्लियर है, इफ यू ट्रेन योर स्टाफ और एनीवन फॉर दिस मैटर, योर लाइफ विल बी रियली रियली सिंप्लीफाइड. दैट्स व्हाट आई थिंक. सेल्स इंटरेस्टिंग, यहाँ पे भी हमने ये चार लेजर, अब सबको पता है कि ड्यूटीज का लेजर भी खोलना है, तो लगे हाथ, लेट मी ओपन दैट ड्यूटीज लेजर आल्सो. सीजीएसटी अंडर ड्यूटीज एंड टैक्सेस, अंडर जीएसटी, अंडर सी है तो सेंट्रल टैक्स हो जाएगा, परसेंटेज हम बोलते हैं यहाँ पे भी डिफाइन मत करो. ओके आइडियली जब से यू नो एनुअल रिटर्न 9 हैज कम, आई हैव स्टार्टेड सजेस्टिंग पीपल डोंट ओनली ओपन वन लेजर सीजीएसटी, ओपन इनपुट सीजीएसटी एंड आउटपुट सीजीएसटी विच विल हेल्प यू एट द टाइम ऑफ क्लोजर. और जब आप एनुअल रिपोर्ट बनाते हो, जीएसटी के बहुत सारे रिपोर्ट बनते हैं, एट दैट टाइम एक्चुअली इट विल सेफगार्ड यू और सेव यू. सी क्या होता है, आई हैव टू हैव अ 6 डिफरेंट लेजर, दैट्स ओनली द इश्यू, बट दैट विल गिव मी रिपोर्ट्स. व्हाई आई एम टेलिंग यू व्हाट प्रॉब्लम हैपेंस, वंस आई ओपन ओनली सिंगल सीजीएसटी अकाउंट, देयर विल बी इनपुट सीजीएसटी कमिंग, देयर विल बी आउटपुट सीजीएसटी कमिंग इन वन लेजर ओनली. Then there will be debit card also coming and credit card also coming. Sales return, purchase return, kuch bhi ho, anything happens will be parked in this account only. So you will be, you know, wasting so much time in segregating all that figures. So instead of that, why don't I create a ledger in the initial inception time only when I start my company? I put input CGST, that will save my time. So anything related to input or purchase return be OI, so that GST is for related to my purchase only, will be parked in my input account. So I have a proper reporting. This is my way of looking the things. Okay. I will like to do that way. Up to you how you can do. Okay. Or input mein rounding off generally not applicable. We should put not applicable. Why? See, if I am issuing the bill, no, the control is in my hand. When outward supply, I can have normal rounding. Purchase is coming from somebody else. Now that person has not rounded off. Why you will write your rounding and all that? Understand? Then again, while doing the two-year reconciliation, there will be differential figures coming. So avoid this rounding off when you are doing input purchase as well as input CGST account. Understand? Because this is coming from outside sources. It is not I am designing this. Okay? So not applicable. And not applicable as the case may be. I am doing control R, input SGST, GST, state tax, and then undefined is not a good sign of doing, and our IGST, integrated goods and service tax. I always believed, you know, if government would have asked me only one country, one tax, only IGST I would have kept. And rest, they should have done from the back end instead of wasting so much human time and energy for no rhyme and reason, you know. So this has become input. We will have output also, correct? You can put your thought process in chat box. Janak will read out for me the time when I'm creating the ledger. Janak, it should be something you can prompt out.
Yes, ma'am. I'm seeing the chat box.
I ask the audience to be engaged. Just don't be a mock spectator.
Yes.
They can keep writing something, no?
Yeah.
It should be not a monologue, no? See what happens, this session gets recorded. So my intention is always that whenever someone refers to video also, they will get the full from start to end the idea about GST configuration. Now this much has been done. So we can also, right now also, I also advise people that RCM also segregate. At the time of GST R9, who will sit and find out again where RCM charge and all that. So tax on RCM is one ledger we open under loans and advance. Then I open tax on advance receipt. It is a pass-through account for creation of the entries. And then input CGST RCM. RCM I segregate, you know. Duties and taxes. GST, central tax. See, this is what we have learned through the time and again. Now 4 years have passed. GST hello has come. So, see, everything comes by experience. For us, it was a new law. So everything was taken care of. The moment you keep on working, you will design your new things coming up as and when required. Percentage I am not defining because we know group will take care item group or item a stock item will take care of the percentage. We are not writing GST percentage here. Okay, so output liability भी तो decide करनी पड़ेगी ना हमको. Why I am doing this exercise is that to this is foundation. If you are okay with this, everything others will fall in place. You know. So fine, I bypassed. Okay. Now let's go to some datas create. वो हम transactions के level पे तो एक दो datas भी अभी create ही कर देते हैं. Ledger में जाके Mr. A is my sundry datas. Yes. Yes, sir. You know, this are why this is like SAP only. Delhi has given you so many fields which you should educate your staff that fill in properly. So everything comes in place. Activate interest calculation. मैंने while F11 features I have activated, so it is prompting me. So it's up to me if I have to charge the interest. I have to enable this. Yes. A. Then there is a Maharashtra, India pin code. अगर जो भी है आपका लिखना है, आप लिख सकते हैं. Mobile number. This can work as your directory also. You key in the data. Mobile number here. Provide contact details. Yes. You have written the contact person also. Mr. A is the person. 999 जो भी उसका नंबर है, फिर उसके बाद फैक्स, ईमेल, एवरीथिंग. सो वंस यू क्रिएट द लेजर, यू इनपुट ऑल दिस डेटाबेस हियर व्हिच विल एनेबल यू व्हाइल यू वांट टू सी से सेंड अ रिपोर्ट इमीडिएटली यू कैन सेंड एवरीथिंग. यू नो इन इवन दे हैव गिवन टू लेयर्स, ईमेल ईमेल मतलब टू द क्लाइंट एज वेल एज सीसी टू माय सबस्टाफ हूसोएवर आई वांट टू डू और टू देयर सबस्टाफ डिपेंडिंग ऑन द रिक्वायरमेंट. This provide bank details is more applicable as far as creditor is concerned. Datas में इसका इतना importance नहीं है क्योंकि वहाँ से आ रहा है मेरे को payment. Okay. Now in datas, if it is a regular PAN number, you can put let me get one number. So this becomes your debtors. यहाँ पे ये when you do the yes, Delhi has also given you the inside pop-up window. You can depending on your requirement use it. Okay. Then Mr. B is our sundry creditors. So okay, fine. I'll keep it like this only for you. Control V is working. That's fine. Mr. B is done. Then we'll have one lawyer from each. We want to syndicators for expense करके group भी create कर सकते हो. You can drill down to the layers whatever you want. Then yes, TDS is deductible and it is individual HUF resident. And yes, अच्छा यहाँ पे भी कुछ है नहीं तो I will create the item. Okay, so I'll create the item for TDS on professional fees under section 194J. Code is 94J. Rate for individual with PAN is 10%, without PAN is 20%, 30,000 is the threshold. So these I have created. Okay. So end of list and use advanced TDS entry. Yes. Ignore surcharge exemption limit. Yes, करना है तो वहाँ पे वो ignore कर देगा. और जो भी आपको यहाँ से करना है, अगर lower deduction certificate है तो वो यहाँ पे डालना रहता है. अभी हमारे lawyers सब जो महाराष्ट्र के ही है फॉर एग्जाम्पल, बट इज नॉट हैविंग द पैन एंड इट इज अनरजिस्टर्ड. आई वांट टू शो यू आरसीएम, दैट्स व्हाई वी आर डूइंग दिस. ओके, सो देयर इज नो पैन नंबर गिवन टू मी एंड नहीं, पैन तो मुझे रखना पड़ेगा क्योंकि नहीं तो वो 20% पे काट लेगा. सो लेट्स प्रोवाइड द पैन. सो अप्लाइड करके लिख देते हैं डिडक्टिव रेफरेंस क्या होता है, मुझे भी पता नहीं है. lawyer. So मैंने अभी आपके I have explored with provide when it is applied. Applied नहीं है, क्या लिखा था इधर? Available. Available है तो वो 10% काटता है कि नहीं? I am with you exploring this. Understand that. Okay. The moment lawyer A is there has to be professional fees to be paid, right? And it will be my expenses indirect. Type of ledger, GST applicable. आपको यहाँ पे define करना है करो या फिर at the transaction level करो. TDS yes कर दो क्योंकि TDS काटना है professional fees. Okay, same. मैंने क्यों यहाँ पे define नहीं किया? See, RCM वाला tier है तो आप जब भी when you make the transactions you can configure at that time. You know, that way. Now when you want to cut the TDS, obviously TDS on professional fees, this is third ledger also need to be created. And it will be duties and taxes, and it will be under TDS. Okay, TDS and professional fees. Everything is integrated by tally. So the full khaka, everything has I've been created. Now I want to automize my entry. So to my staff, I will ask. I will make a voucher type for them. The GST. Local and interstate sales transactions also you can segregate, or you can segregate through class. So say GST sales is my main heading under sales. Sales is given by the tally in bill. Then I can have a voucher numbering automatic. So it will take care. I don't need to bother myself. I can have the leeway or it's automatic manual override somewhere if I have some problems. So if I take this, it will ask me prevent duplicate. I will say yes. And I will use advanced configuration. I go to this, the second window will open the prefix, suffix, and the number. So maybe what is numerical part is if 999 invoices are going to be created, you keep 3, and 9999 you keep 4. So if I am keeping 3, and then there is another a prefix with 0, yes, because it is always advisable if 001 is printed in your bill. And then you have the options like GST slash, and then you can have a suffix 2122. Okay, and I'm saving this. After that, you have a default title to print GST invoice. Bank is not there, so I had to create one bank, so that will be printed in my invoice. So that one I missed out. Now here I will write local within state. आपको जो जो ना वट एवर नेम इज यू आर कंफर्टेबल विद यू कैन राइट विद इन स्टेट सो आई विल नॉट एक्सक्लूड बट इंक्लूड व्हाट एनी ट्रांजैक्शन थ्रू बैंक थ्रू कैश थ्रू सन्ड्री डेटर्स ऑल आई विल इंक्लूड एंड लेजर नेम इज लाइक नाउ आई नो इट इज माय क्लास इज विद इन स्टेट आई विल सिलेक्ट दिस एंड देन आई विल मेक इट सीजीएसटी सो इट इज आउटपुट सीजीएसटी एंड देन इट इज आउटपुट एसजीएसटी Okay, so if you have loading, unloading, you can create it and you can park it here and before CGST only you put it there. So it will be example taxes and other charges to be added in invoice can be automated here. Once I save it, then intrastate also we will create. So here the same logic applies. Now OCC maybe if credit is coming, you can take that. So I am including this group. My now that will be interstate sales and then IGST, so output IGST will be my the thing. Okay, so if you want कि मुझे loading unloading भी लगाना है, तो alt C. So here also we given the option to create loading and out of state जा रहा है तो obviously there will be freight charges. Ideally GST में लिख देती हूँ, so मुझे I want that bifurcation. Okay, so it will be under my sales account. Okay. And it will be applicable GST because GST law says anything added into the invoice, GST will take GST has to be charged on that. Okay, so it is a services. Chalo, theek hai, it is safe. So it is what? It is a user defined menu. So you want to put with your hand, remove if zero, if nothing is there, it will not be printed. Otherwise, it will be printed. So IGST, I want output IGST. This exercise if you do and control A, I am saving. So what will help your user that when now I go for a vouchers and if I want to do a sales transaction, FA, GST sales is my heading and in that I have an interstate and within state. So if I say interstate selection, and if I say change mode to item invoice, you can see loading as well as these has been taken care by the tally. By default, it comes. Okay. So this will automate your transaction entry. Now, before selling, let's have some purchase, some volume we will purchase, and then we will do the sales. So I'm doing F9 on 1st April. Now, I always say to the client, see, some people have that habit. Aray, bill late aaya, and almost on a cutoff date. Agar 30th April, if you have purchased something, bill comes to you on a 5th of May. Some factory has that habit, inward date, and on after inward only you do the entry in the books, and then you will take the credit in that date only. So what I say is that transaction date can be say 5 April, and my invoice is say 1, 2, 3, 4, and it can be 1st April. So why these dates are very important, because when you export columnar report in tally of the purchase register, tally allows you invoice date, supplier invoice date, voucher date. So these two dates are very particularly important for you. So when you are booking, so suppose one GST 3B is logged in tally. I uploaded the April month tally, GST 3B for April month, and some purchase invoice comes in the month of May pertaining to April. Please enter in the month of May. See, what will happen that your GST should not get affected. That is what. And the supplier invoice date is already available. That feature is already available. So that once you are using tally for uploading your returns, I think that is the way out. That is from my side. You have to explore when you actually do it. So Mr. B is my creditor. Let me purchase something from them. Purchase ledger is say Maharashtra se hai, so I have to select within state, and then here purchase is taxable. Okay. Name of the item, say Apple mobile. You have a description. Why this is description? So you have a red color, blue color. So you can write red 10 piece, blue 10 piece, whatever. Red to aata hai, usme white aata hai. So white 10 and blue 10. So if I have purchased 20 quantity and say 60,000 is a base value, so this is your purchase. Okay. This has happened, then you will have some USB chargers also you will be doing, and say you are buying 10 pieces or 1,000. Then we had some memory card. So say I'm getting 50 memory cards of say 2,000 rupees. So this is what I have purchased. Okay. Now purchase, there is no voucher class. So I will have to write with my hand input CGST. The moment I put input CGST, the figures are captured by tally. Then I will put input SGST. The figures are captured by tally. And I want to see what is this is all about. I want to see where value kya hai, more details mein kya mujhe dikh raha hai. Kuch GST details dikh rahi hai mujhe yahan pe. E-way bill details dikh rahi hai. Show more. Anything more is there? No. Because I want to see the valuation, tax analysis. Let me just save it and page up. Jana, tally
yes,
bifurcation jo hai GST classification. Okay. So it is a related report. Okay. So Teleprime is new feature for me also, GST tax analysis. All of you can now understand 9, 14, 9. So I have not done anything, only master configuration was proper. Tally has picked up. Are we getting? I need some fatafat.
Yes, there are a couple of questions, sir.
Any interesting answer should be there. See, this is. And this is just two items. You can have n numbers of items. Tally will take care. Okay. So this is how. And provide GST bill details. Yes. And then you can park everything here, and then e-way bill can be generated and portal pay. It goes directly. Okay. So we have saved these transactions. Cool. So I should have one interstate party also for sales. क्योंकि वो ऑटोमेटिक होना चाहिए बिकॉज आई हैव डिफाइंड देयर राइट सो लेट्स डू सम सेल्स इंटरव्यू एंड फर्स्ट आई एम डूइंग इंटरस्टेट ओके यू कैन सी द वाउचर नंबर GST/001 थ्री डिजिट आई हैव डिफाइंडेड 12 इफ आई वुड हैव डिफाइंड 4 डिजिट्स इट वुड हैव कम 4 माने पानी में ना अकॉर्डिंगली इट वर्क्स माने My party is Mr. A, Maharashtra, okay, fine. Memory card, say 2 memory card. Now I purchased in how much? What was the price? 2000. So I'll say 2500. Then Apple, 165,000. अब देखो आपको समझ में आ रहा है I wanted participant कि मैंने देखो interstate लिया Mr. A is from local so that is where the tally is taking यहाँ पे there is no figure output I just see otherwise if I would have taken digit state and just see the transactions how it happens. Now if I put memory card, I put 2 memory cards with 2500, see the GST figures automatic comes. I wanted to show you. That's why I took interstate. The party is interstate nahi hai, to agar if your accountant is doing this mistake, error, the tally will not calculate anything because tally understands ki wo class kuch aur liya hai, party kuch aur. See the selection of party is different and the class is different. So it is a internal control, internal check is there within the tally itself. Understand? And then I wanted to highlight. Kya hota hai when I'm entering the entry, you're focusing on just entry, how I'm doing. If you are not realizing, I have selected a wrong class and that's why the no amount was coming there. See, the moment I put 65,000, tally is calculating it. That is what is beauty of tally. अभी चार्जर भी बेचता ही पड़ेगा ना तो रेट ऑफ परसेंटेज डिफरेंट डिफरेंट पता चलेगा ओके सो दैट वाज इन रिलेटेड रिपोर्ट्स जीएसटी टैक्स एनालिसिस ऑल एफ 1 9 9 एंड 14% आर वी हैप्पी सो दैट इज व्हाट आई वांटेड टू हाईलाइट टुडे कि इफ यू डेटा एंट्री इज डन करेक्टली ठीक है वो हो गया आपका काम अब हम जाएंगे डीओजी फर्स्ट लेट्स सी GSTR 1 इट इज डन प्रॉपरली ऑल्ट F1 रिटर्न व्यू यू कैन सी रिटर्न व्यू B2B इनवॉइसेस हुआ है देन आप पोर्टल पे डायरेक्ट अपलोड भी कर सकते हैं एक्सेल में एक्सपोर्ट भी कर सकते हैं When I export it, see, it is giving me an option Excel, CSV, JSON. So you can create JSON and then upload the return. Excel means you can have a database readily available to yourself for viewing purpose. Right now, suppose if I am just saving it, I will again go to configuration board because I missed out something. I will go to the export. Then e-return, then Excel, then you can have a specification of path wherever you want to save. Just bring it from file browser, file explorer, and then save it over here. Right now I'm not meddling with it. Okay, so I'll just save it this. I wanted to export document summary. So it was yes. So it should be yes for you to just export it and then send it. How much time we have? We have sufficient.
Madam, we are.
Sufficient time is there. 15-20 minutes more. And see yes, here only B2B, I think B2B was there. So it will come here B2B, control home. This is how it comes. Regular and 18 and 28%. Okay, 17,000, 1500. So my GSR1 is done, my HSN is done, control home. That my tally has given me HSN my summary also. Okay. One input from my side for Janak, kindly just jot it down. Yesterday when I was doing GSCR1, here in this particular sheet, if you can provide me with the percentage also, because while we upload, they are asking me percentage wise bifurcation also.
Okay.
So somewhere something was going haywire. Somewhere I had some issues. So I thought if you can provide me that column, can save my time, you know. Otherwise, I had to do R&D again and again. Okay. So GSCR1 we have taken care of. GSCR3B is also readily available for us. If we say the eligible ITC is also available and my supply is also available to me. Now let me have one transaction of lawyer so that what will. So abhi tally me kaisa hai three. You are right now at 3B. You can immediately go to Alt G and you will have a create voucher. I like this feature so much and so I use it extensively. Okay, I say any expenses where there is a GST also, matlab expense also, you can use the purchase module so that you have an invoice number tracking. Okay, understand my word. Use, say you are receiving telephone bill where you want to claim the GST input credit. You are receiving courier bill. Use this purchase module. What will happen? There is a reference number tagging is there. So when you are reconciling 2A in the Excel VLOOKUP, you will have this facility. And in the next version of Tally, maybe certain 2A reconciliation is also bound to come. Let's wait and watch for the next week. Okay. So somebody had asked that question. So that will be taken care of there. Right now it is in a primitive A. There is also one version. You can have a 2 downloaded and just reconcile. JSN download. You have to download 2A JSN from the website. Match it with GSCR2 shown in the tally. It will give you whatever is matching with the green, you know, green color. And if there is a problem, it will highlight in a red color. Someone has asked question, Janak, I have addressed that. Okay. Yeah. On a, I will pass the journal entry. Why? Because RCM in any case, he doesn't, I don't need a reference number. So it depends. I can always pass through purchase also. There is nothing. See, purchase ke through B, I can book. But I will just change a mode because it will be an accounting invoice. Lawyer is a, but it's not an item. Itemizing this. Change the mode and say on a 5th April, he's sending me say 1-2 number ka bill. Okay. Exactly. And then party's name is say lawyer. So I will book the bill, say professional fees paid and for attending GST litigation. Okay. Litigation. And then he's charging me say 50,000, the first bill. Okay. So classification purchase under reverse charge, taxable. Unregistered dealer, but I have to tax it, right? So what will happen after this? If I have to cut the TDS, I have to write TDS and professional fees. So my tally 10% automatically doing. I have not done that 5,000 minus. Okay. Then I say new reference 50, keep on entering. So it will reduce that 5,000 and book the bill. I'm overriding it. And now let me see my 3B is showing me what. It is showing me uncertain transactions. So what is the problem? Let us understand what is the problem. Maine jo bhi kharida hai to usme 18% lagega. That wanted me to put the transactions purchased from unregistered dealer hai na taxable. Now it has moved out. Whatever we are doing is to show you that this are the important points you need to put in so that this transaction. Now the tally is giving you an idea. Reverse charge liability and input credit to be booked. So you go to URD purchase. I have just pressed enter and it is showing me total liability is this percentage, unless I define how on this earth Tally will come to know ki RCM kitna book karna hai, what is your liability. So that's why it was to be booked as a percentage over there. Now here is something called state adjustment. So may I click on that state adjustment, and it will ask me increase of tax liability and input tax credit. This you can use when I'm increasing and taking set off in the same transaction. No, but I just want to increase tax liability. Why? Because during the month there will be 10 transaction of URD, and after I make the payment only I am eligible to take input tax credit. So I have an option. I just press space bar and I can say just increase of tax liability. Mujhe, I want to increase my tax liability. I can park that entry on 5th of April also, or at the end of the month, depending on the firm's policy. So what I'm right now booking is output CGST RCA. I know it is 4,500, and I'm sorry, book karna hai to it has to be credit. So what is the pass through account is tax on RCA, loans and advance, it will get debited by 9,000. I'm extremely sorry, to output CGST RCA. Now it will ask me what percentage. So it is 9% on 50,000. Okay, here also the amount comes by default by that 9,000. So I have to key in 4,500, then output SGST RCA. Now Tally has that ability, the last transaction it picks up. So 9% it picked up from the last one I key in, so the same will come here. Okay, and I want to give a details, provide GST details, you can say yes, and then you can write services. Okay, so here also RCM on capital goods, services that they have option, they have now given, you know, so lawyer, and I have saved it. Okay, so now it has booked, mein chala gaya, balance liability zero ho gaya. So obviously now we'll make the payment. So I do Alt G, I want to enter the voucher, so create voucher, and then I want to do the F5 payment, because eligibility of RCM set off is on the basis of payment. Now in payment, I have an option called state adjustment. And then what I'm doing is payment under reverse charge. So that I have to select. See, you have to select proper classification adjustments. Then only Tally will automatically understand what this transaction is partaking the characteristic. Okay. So I will make it down. And now payment में मुझे क्या करना था, मैंने एक output liability create की थी, तो I will have to make the payment of the same. To buy output SGST RCA 4,500 and to what bank, जो हमने अब तक create नहीं की थी, से HDFC bank, and then the bank accounts, and then यहाँ पे भी if you have already activate interest calculation, choice is yours, account number is your whatever number is there. That you need to put. IFS code also. All this information will be printed in your invoice if you insert it over here. मैंने कौन सा लिया? इसके लिए मैं ये ले रहा हूँ. मेरा favorite bank, Bank of Baroda. Now here there is no control. ऊपर आप क्या लिख रहे हैं उसके साथ वो match नहीं कर रहा है. Understand that. So branch कोई भी है आपकी, मेरी है बुरी, बुरी will be best. बहुत कुछ है, बैंक रिकंसिलेशन पे एक पूरा सेशन हो सकता है. एनीवेज, सो इट्स बाय ई फंड ट्रांसफर, एंड हियर यू कैन मेंशन 4,500, एंड हियर यू कैन मेंशन एसजीएसटी आरसीएम ई फंड ट्रांसफर 4,500, एंड आई सेव द ट्रांजैक्शन. ओके, सो वी क्रिएटेड आउटपुट लायबिलिटी, वी मेड द पेमेंट. नाउ ऑब्वियसली आई नीड टू बुक दैट इनपुट क्रेडिट. सो आई विल गो टू माय जर्नल वाउचर F7. After F7, I will do the state adjustment. It is a GST adjustment, and now it is increase of input tax credit. After making payment, I will book this transaction. And here I know it is purchased under reverse charge. Yeah, it was purchased from unregistered dealer. This is under unregistered dealer. Yeah, reverse charge means transportation will go under reverse charge, because sometimes transporter have GST number, but still if it is under reverse charge, I will have to make a payment. Here lawyer is obviously unregistered, and that's why I am making the payment. Okay, So now what will I will gain? I will gain input CGST RCM. So again, Delhi is asking me what percentage and what amount. So I'm just putting it over here. Okay. And there we go. This is journal entry, right? So tax on RCM account has some balance, which I will knock off. And then provide GST details, say yes. So here, which period you are accounting this for reverse charge on services, and that's how it is saved. So now if I go to 3B, what is available to me? Let me see. So now here you can say inward supply liable to reverse charge, Tally has picked up 4,500. Inward supply liable to eligible ITC also it is available. So the full cycle gets over like this. Now I will take one transaction. But now Tally will work in a 64-bit system. The question is Windows 10 or XP is the operating system. Windows, that PC bit system should be 64-bit. Okay. So we have 3B. So ideally what we were wanted to show you is that now once you do the GST at 3B, Alt F1, everything is done. I can open this for you more करके hide and then go to export. Export में e-return and then Excel or JSON, either way. Now here in 3B, one requirement is asked by the Tally. I will show you just now. It will automatically tell you Excel utility. So you need to download from the website the Excel utility 4.7. And then 3B will be exported. So you should be having that utility downloaded in your system. So let me check if I have, or else we need to download and how it will look like. Utility need to be there, no? Here it is there. See, you can see 4.6 excellence and 4.6 utility is there. So 4.7, you can go to GST website and you can download that utility. Downloads. GST at 3B offline utility. Okay, so where I will download, that is very important. So my data path is here. So if I want to space either or, I can pick up from here or I specify path. So whatever path I am downloading it now,
ma'am, we have 10 minutes in the session.
Hey, what is happening?
Yes, ma'am.
Nahi, what is happening? Wo escape karte na, wo floating window aa jata na, to dikhta nahi hai. We have 4 or 5 minutes more to show them because this is very important. Hardly people show it, expect here. So now you have 4.7 excellence here only. So if I take this control C and I take control V here, and then I say enter and then enter, so automatically it will go to send. Okay. this is how JSTOP3D is exported and readily available in DALL-E. We have, and JSM also you can do. Animal content. So if you can see, everything will come here. The number, tally, JST, whatever name, seed status, validation failed. Kuch galat hoga, to it will prompt you to validate. Seed validated. Please proceed to generate JSM file. Okay. So this import supply reverse charge has come here. And input credit also it has taken care of, you know. Here my outward supply, inward supply liable to reverse charge has come. And this JSM has been done. So this is how the whole process can be done from DALL-E itself. That's what I wanted to showcase. So from my side, it is over. And also, one last thing. If the data is properly configured, JSTOP 9 also, it you will get all the information, then only little workaround has to be done. And suppose you wanted to see this. I can show you from some company. What I showed you was I opened 2021 and here it is GST annual return. Any uncertain transaction you need to address to Alt F1, everything will come under the format which you want. And if you have properly configured inputs, IDs, inputs, capital goods, services, everything was taken care by DALL-E. So from my side, Janak, I have winding up. I have yes, another. Lectures waiting for me to join there.
Yeah, so we'll take one question, one or two questions we still have. So Venkatesh is asking, how do we track HSN and purchases, goods and services?
That track bolega to everything is there, na? Tally, whenever you go here, see, update party GST, there is something, HSN report is also there, na? There was somewhere secretary report, JC reports. Whenever you are entering here, it is showing you the HSN summary. Now, which period I am in? So, I will have to change your period. And HSN summary is you require in JSTOP 1, if I'm not mistaken, right? So I go to JSTOP 1. Included in HSN summary 9 items. Here you have to, it shows you HSN, description, and whatever. I think that is the, that may be the answer.
Yes.
For him.
So, Venkatesh, if you have any other questions or some follow-up, you can use the chat or the Q&A also. Megha Chandradeep is asking, can you brief us a little about what is eWaybill and how a tally can be useful?
I couldn't hear your voice, Janak. Wow, low volume, Arashan.
Okay, is it audible now?
Well, what was your question?
So Megha Chandradeep is asking, what is eWaybill and how DALL-E can help it?
E-way bill to the session itself, not my forte, dear.
Yes. So in fact, if you see, no, Megaji, there is an entire provision in Tally. There will be only a lot of resources. Head for tallysolutions.com. How to generate e-way bill? What are the capabilities? In fact, let me also now disclose only. Very soon we will be coming out with release 2.0 in 1 or 2 weeks. It will have advanced e-way bill capabilities, whereby you will have lot of expert features and ability to generate e-way bill from Tally itself. So do stay tuned in. We will be also conducting many webinars on that front. So all those webinars now will be going on this website. So in the chat box, I'm leaving a link of our community page. So all the updates, all the webinars that are happening will be updated over here. Yes, one now. Any other questions? Anything else, we'll be more than happy to take it. Thank you for the seminar. Yes, thank you. Anonymous attendee as
Abhi, now see, he's asking HSN on purchase. Now purchase, sir, what to when you are buying from someone, he has to print in his bill. No, GST invoice will always carry HSN number. See, you when you sell, you are writing HSN. When you buy, you will get that number. Now why?
Yes. So any other question or Vanna madam, shall we wrap it up? Even
yes,
I think it is your time also.
Go now.
Yeah, you have Vanna madam has certain commitments. But let me now wholeheartedly thanks Vanna madam for coming on behalf of the forum and on behalf of Vanna madam and Team Tally. Let me thank all the members who are with us. Still 52 members. It is a big deal for us. And yeah, so next week again we will send out the invite for the next week's session shortly. Again, if you're going to be with Vanna madam, the invite session will go out by Monday. So yeah, so see you till next time. Bye everyone.